Okay, so in the last tutorial, I quickly showed you how to create a simple beat pattern with Redrum in Reason. And the pattern sounds like this. And in this tutorial, we'll be looking at how to assign individual effects to the different instrument channels in Redrum. You know, many years ago, when I didn't know anything about Reason really, and I was completely new, and I wanted to have, let's say, a reverb effect on the bass drum and a delay on the snare drum, then I had to create one Redrum instrument for the bass drum and put the reverb effect on that, and I create another Redrum for the snare drum to put the individual, you know, effect on that one, and it just became really a bunch of Redrums with one instrument on each, just because I wanted different effects on them, on the different instruments. But that's surely a really not good and optimal way to do it. So what you want to do is assign the different effects directly to these channels. So if you click tab, you change the view to the back side of the rack, and this is where you will have a lot of fun. So let's just bring up the tool window and choose a few effects that we want. Maybe have some reverb and a delay line, maybe a phaser, and maybe the alligator filter gate, pulverizer maybe. Okay, so I'm gonna assign one of these to four different channels on the Redrum. So I switch it. Yeah, of course. First, I'd like to take line mixer. And the mixer is where I will route the different channels to. Or routes, yeah. So I'll begin by just removing all of this noise. Now, we will start with the bass drum. So I will connect the bass drum to the reverb. So I switch the view. And the bass drum lies on the first channel. So I will drag this, just click and hold up to the reverb. Boom, like that. And now, if you push the key, you will hear that you cannot hear anything because the sound now goes into the reverb, but the reverb isn't connected to anything. So we will take the output on the reverb and drag it up to the audio in on the line mixer. And there you have it. Now the bass drum is connected with the reverb effect. Actually, I don't want it. I want it to be delayed instead. That's cooler. That's just so much cooler, man. Okay, so next snare drum. So I'll take the delay, I mean the reverb, on the snare instead. So we can see that the snare is on channel 2. So we flip it over and we drag this up to the reverb input. Boom. No sound, so we have to take the reverb in the same way up to channel 2 on the mixer. And now the snare has reverb. So the bass drum has a cool delay line, and the snare drum has some nice reverb. And maybe this, which is on channel 4, we can put on the phaser, flip it over again. So we take channel 4 up to the phaser, boom. And we connect the phaser to, I'll take channel 4 for it. Now. And last but not least, we'll take this and connect it to the pulverizer. Number three, inputs. And the output. Boom. Yes, so now let's listen to our beat pattern, see what happens. Yes. So that's how you assign effects to each individual channel in Redrum. In the next tutorial, I guess we will take a look at edit automation. That way you can edit stuff like this. In the track. So, that's for the next tutorial. Peace out.